Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what is row level security in Power BI, or in short, RLS in Power BI. Let us try to understand what is this using our business scenario, Naga Garments. We are exploring Power BI using this garments business, and today he has a question like, the manager in Bangalore should see only his data. We have seen in our previous video, like we have developed the dashboard and we have deployed it in the Power BI services. As soon as the manager of the Bangalore branch logs in, he should see only his data. And we have shared his report to all the managers of Chennai, Bangalore, Hyderabad. Right now, they can able to see all the data irrespective of the filters. So how to do it? This is called row level security, basically applying the security restriction at the data level. That is what the name called row level security. This scenario can be applied to many other business scenarios, like it can be applied to regions, it can be applied to departments, it can be applied to different products. So there are different business scenarios you can use. Let us see it in a demo. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI. We are in Power BI desktop now. We are familiar with this report. The same report, we have deployed it in Power BI services as well. Now, he is a user who has created this. I logged in using Nags, okay, Naga. So he's admin, or he's the main user who created this. Whoever created has all the access. Now, what we need to do is, like, this report has to be shared to another user, right? And we are fine with this. Okay. So let me sign in using another user over here. Right now, what happens, okay? Now we have this account. He's the user who is Bangalore branch manager. Now let us see what he can look here. We already shared him this report, so he can able to see this report over here, right over here. Now as soon as he logs in, he can able to see everything. Okay, now you can see this username. Let me move this one here. So here it is, he's Lax, okay? He's lax.analytics.com. He's another user, okay? Now he can see everything. As soon as he logs in, he has to see only the Bangalore location. Let's see, like, his data is for Bangalore 4142-1900. That is what he has to see, okay? Let us see how we can do it. For that, I need to be back to our Power BI desktop. What we need to do is, so based on different filter criteria, you need to create some rules. So go to modeling and create manage rules. Let us try to create one role. That is, I think here itself we have a role. Let me delete this. So let me rename it to Bangalore branch access, okay, something like that. Bangalore branch, it's a name. And what you want here, I want, like, I already used some filters over here. That's what it's appearing now. You can see, like, add filter. When you right click on this particular table and location, put it over here. So location equal to Bangalore. So the spelling should be exactly matching whatever your data is all about. If you see here, if you type it wrongly, it is Bangalore, okay? So it should be like this, okay? It should be exactly same as your, as in your data. Now he is the Bangalore branch manager. He can able to access only Bangalore. What you are doing, as soon as this user logs in, this filter applied, so all the records pertaining to this particular location only fed into this report layout. That is what it is happening. I can also create another role saying that Chennai branch. Now once again I apply location Chennai. Okay, so I have created two roles over here. This is what you need to do it in your Power BI desktop. So basically now you have created two roles and you want to test this role. Now you need to apply, add those users, whoever has Power BI access, to this role. So if you are adding a branch manager, Bangalore branch manager in the Bangalore role, and you can add a Chennai branch manager in the Chennai role. That is what you need to do. That you can do it in Power BI service. Right now, here I want to ensure it is working fine or not. So there is option called View As. So you go here and you can choose this one and press OK. As soon as you press it here, you can see the report filtered to, let me move this one down. So it is filtered to Bangalore only. You also remember this figure 1421900. Even I can stop this one, stop viewing this. So now I want to see the Chennai branch. Let us see that. Now viewing the data as Chennai. Now this is the figure. Okay. Now stop viewing. I hope you understand this option, like why you need this one. View as like testing in your desktop, whether that particular role is working fine or not. Okay. Now, once you are defined your roles, then tested it's working fine, you need to deploy this report. Go to home, publish, save. So it will deploy in your workspace. It is already existing. Let us replace it. Now, once you deployed, just move to your Power BI report. Then go to your data sets. Okay. Basically, you are not doing anything over your reports. You are restricting the row level security in the data sets. You need to go to data sets, then security. There you go. Here you have like two different roles that define. You need to add users over here. For him, I want to add this user. I have only this user. I just added. For him, I don't have any other users. Just ignore it. So for now, we have added one particular user here as a Bangalore branch manager. This is done. And this particular report, I already shared to this user. We can check it whether I have shared or not. Access, go to access. So you see this is the user. Already I have shared it, so I'm not resharing. You need to ensure for whoever a new user you are giving access to, you the security you are giving is for the data, and this is sharing is for the report level access. Okay, two different concepts. Now, once I go and log in here, earlier when I logged in, there is no row level security applied for this user. Let us try to go to home and try to launch it now. What happened? There you go. When I refresh it, it is catchied. Before I launching, when I refresh it, you can able to see only the Bangalore. So going forward, what happens whenever he clicks on the report, he can see only the Bangalore data. You remember this figure 1421900 is your Bangalore figure. We can check it once again. So 1421900. So this is what row level security is all about. To summarize, you need to create a role and you can test the role in your modeling tab, and then you deploy the report in your Power BI services. In the services, go to data sets. In data sets, you add the users in your security tab. I hope you guys like this video. Do subscribe to the channel and comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.